about sedimentology and the sedimentary rocks. Let me tell you what sedimentology is all about. Sedimentology is the study of the process of formation, transport and deposition of material that accumulates as sediments in continental and marine environments and eventually forms sedimentary rock. Now, heading to this diagram, what we can see here that the pre-existing rock already at a high elevated areas, it has been worn down by the process of weathering and eroded, then transported and deposited. Finally, these fine sediments when deposited into the basin, which is definitely a oceanic floor or some lake floor or sometime depression on the earth crust. It is lithified and diagenesis process takes place. The lithification and diagenetic process converts these loose sediment particles into sedimentary rock. So these five processes are extremely important: weathering, erosion, transport, deposition, lithification and diagenesis. The sedimentary rock are generally broadly classified into four basic categories like cataclastic, non-clastic, evaporites and biogenic. Now with the further I'll be dealing with all type of processes in brief. So guys, welcome to Introduction to Sedimentary Rocks and Their Origin. Welcome to my YouTube channel Geology with Saran. The term sedimentology was defined by Waddell in 1932 as the study of sediments. Sediments have been defined as what settles at the bottom of a liquid, dredges and deposit. Sedimentology is generally deemed to embrace chemical precipitates like salts as well as true detrital deposits. Sedimentology is the study of the processes of formation, transport and deposition of material that accumulates as sediments in continental and marine environment and eventually forms sedimentary rock. Now here this is a diagrammatic representation of formation of sedimentary rock. This is an uplifted area, erosion is taking place. Finally, these loose sediments are being transported and they are deposited. Then again it is under the tremendous amount of pressure and temperature, it is again lithified and again the rock is uplifted and the cycle goes on. The major steps are weathering, erosion, transportation, deposition and diagenesis. Now what are the processes involved in the formation of sedimentary rock? First is weathering. This is the initiation of the formation of loose unconsolidated particles by transforming solid rock into fragments or dissolved ions by physical and chemical weathering. Then comes erosion. This is a very complex process involving many agents which works as unison and degrades the surface of the earth by carrying the loose sediments along with them under the influence of gravity. The next step is transportation. The agent which carries these sediments by sliding downslope, they are being picked up by wind, running water or stream or ocean currents. The ability of the agent to carry the load depends upon the energy it possesses. Higher the energy, heavier the sediment that can be picked to a more distance and can be traveled and transported. Then comes the process of deposition. The carried sediments are deposited when the energy of transporting medium becomes too low to continue the transportation process. The size of the particle keeps on decreasing as we go far from the source. Then comes your lithification and diagenesis. Lithification is the process that turns loose sediment into rock. The first stage involves compaction due to the overweight of the sediments. This forces the grains close together, reducing pore space and oozing interstitial waters from the grains. During this, many mineral precipitates and bind to the loose particles. This process is known as cementation. Now the process of sediment generation and deposition are as follows. Here you can see that all the this fundamental science is all connected to sedimentology, the physics, chemistry and biology. All the processes involved results in the formation of sediment. This is how the weathering and erosion takes place. The sediment is transported. and is be deposited into the basins, and then finally the burial, compaction and lithification process takes place. Now we'll come on the types of sedimentary rocks. First is terrigenous clastic, which is also known as clastic rock. This is a material that is made up of particles or clast derived from pre-existing rock by weathering and erosion, comprising largely of silicate minerals. Some of the rocks formed by this process are conglomerates and breccia, sandstone, siltstone and shale. The other category of the rock is non-clastic or chemically precipitated. These are the rocks which are formed as a result of dissolved ions in water and are precipitated in suitable environment. Example, evaporites, siliceous sedimentary rock. The next category is biogenetic or bioclastic rocks. These are the rocks which are formed by the sediment derived from the living organisms, for instance, shells of marine organisms and other invertebrates. About 10 to 15% of the sedimentary rocks are formed by this process. Example, limestone, chalk, etc. Now, various environments for deposition of sedimentary rocks are given here. This is an alluvial fan. This is the glacial deposits. These are the small lakes or lacustrine deposits, followed by a depression where evaporite deposition takes place. These are the aeolian, formed by wind. These are the fluvial channel in which the sediments have been carried, and this is a delta deposit. And here comes the deep marine deposits, and here comes the shallow water deposits. Now this is a Wentworth scale for the size of the grain. This is a 5 scale, and here it is into mm. The size of the particle, if it is more than 256 mm, we consider it as a boulder. From 256 to 4 mm, we say it as pebble. From 4 to 2 mm, we say it is gravel. 2 to 0.5 is a very coarse and coarse sand. 0.5 to 0.25 it's the medium sand. And 0.25 to 0.06 is a fine and very fine sand. 0.06 to 0.004 we have silt, and less than 0.004 we consider it as clay. Now I'll discuss some common sedimentary rocks with you. The first is the conglomerate and breccia. These are the coarse grain clastic rocks whose size is more than 2 mm in diameter, and they are held together by cement of fine grain clastic matrix. In a conglomerate, the particles are round, showing higher degree of transportation, which is responsible for rounded grain boundary. Whereas in sedimentary breccia, the grains are angular and generally found close to the weathering site, the clasts retain most of the characteristics of the parent rock. Next comes the sandstone. Now sandstone consists of lithified sand grains. The word sandstone refers to any classic sedimentary rock comprising primarily of sand-sized grains, quartz. Quartz is the mineral which is most resistant of weathering, so most of the sandstone have quartz in them. So generally 90% of them have quartz. A rock is said to be sandstone is categorized as arcos if it has 25% or more feldspar grain, with most of the remaining as quartz. The class Weke is a poorly sorted sandstone with considerable amount of silt and clay in its pore. They are commonly dark in color because of the fine clay that coats the sand grain, which are mainly of quartz and feldspar. Next comes claystone, shale, mudstone and siltstone. They all are fine grained clastic rocks. Claystone is comprises of predominantly of clay and a small amount of quartz and other clay sized particles. Shale consists of same material but has layered structures, which is a very characteristic feature of shale, that is fissility, along which the rock splits. And the mudstone is a non-fissile rock composed of clay and silt. Now we have the chert. It is a rock composed of pure silica, occurs as sedimentary bed interlayered with other sedimentary rocks as irregularly shaped lumps, which are referred as nodules. Flint is a dark variety that was frequently used as arrowheads, spears and other chipped tools. Then we have coal. The undecayed or partially decayed plant remains forms peat, which is then buried and compacted by overlying sediments, and then it is converted into hard resistant rock known as coal, and it is a combustible rock. Next comes the category of evaporites. They are formed when evaporation concentrates dissolved iron to the point at which they precipitate and interlock with each other to produce grains. Some minerals found in evaporites are like gypsum and halite. In my further lecture, I'll show you the images of these rocks as well. Then we have carbonate rocks. They are mainly composed of carbonate minerals which contains carbonate ions. The most common mineral is calcite, which is calcium carbonate, and dolomite. Dolomite is calcium magnesium carbonate. Calcium rich rocks are called limestone and magnesium rich rocks are called dolomite or dolostone. Then we have coquina. It is a bioclastic limestone consisting wholly of coarse shell fragments cemented together. Chalk is very fine grained soft white bioclastic limestone made up of shell and skeleton of microorganisms that float near the surface of the earth. Then we have sandstone. The image is showing you various types of sandstone. As you can see here, there are the different types of sandstones which has been the signature of their mineral composition. Here you can see the class which is rounded in shape. So we consider these type of class as a rounded class, or we can say is a conglomerate rock is formed by these class. And here you can see the angular fragments of the class. That's why the rock which is formed by these angular class is known as breccia. Here we have evaporitic rock. This is a gypsum rock and this is a halite. Then here you can see coal. This is chalk. These are the deposits of some microorganisms and shells. And here are the bivalvian shell. Thank you for watching the lecture. Thank you.